Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, hello and welcome to Ascension to Love with Alice, a return to union. It's so wonderful to be here with you as we do this weekly energy forecast for Monday the 28th of September all the way through to Sunday the 4th of October. It is a big week for cosmic transits, to say the least. It's a very, very big week. We've got a full moon in Aries coming up on the 1st. We've got what else have we got? We've got Mercury going into Scorpio. We've got Venus going into Virgo on the 2nd. We've got Saturn going direct in Capricorn. Saturn's been in retrograde since May, sometime in May. And Saturn is that planet of karma, right? So quite a big shift to happen there. We've also got Pluto, which is the planet of like death and rebirth, right? So really incredible, call it a planet if you want, you don't have to. But Pluto is going direct, and it's also the planet of the subconscious, and that's been in retrograde since April. So there is a lot going on for this week. It's going to be a very energetic week, to say the least. So I'm really excited to delve into what themes we've got coming in. But before we do that, I just want to let you all know that we still have Akashic Record sessions on special this week until the end of September. They were a special for the month of September to help you shift through anything that you're struggling to shift through, especially with having that 9-9 portal coming up to the 10-10 portal of completion, double completion energy. So Akashic Records and past life healing and karma balancing are still on special, so grab those while you can. And we also have specials coming up as well for the full moon and for the 10-10 portal, which is always very exciting. So do check out my Facebook page if you are not already on there. So that's Ascension to Love with Alice on Facebook. There's different content on the Facebook page, so do make sure that you hit the like and the subscribe on both YouTube and Facebook. I appreciate you so much for being here. Thank you for all that are returning. And welcome to those that are new. I'm really looking forward to seeing what we've got coming up. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So I want to find out, you guys, what themes do we have coming up for this week? So let's get a few cards full of themes of what is happening this week. So we've got conclusions are within reach coming out straight away. We've got you and your loved ones are safe, new moon in Cancer energy, so that's good. We've got conclusion, we've got new moon energy coming straight through, and we've got hold your vision. Okay, and we've got have faith in your dreams coming up at the bottom of the deck here. So already we've got things concluding, which doesn't surprise me. You know, we're in the prelim of of the 10-10 portal, right? So this week is going to take us all the way through to the 4th of October, which is the week before that 10-10 portal. We've got that full moon happening in the middle of the week, which is all about release. And we've got two full moons this month as well, right? So we've got a blue moon at the end of the month. So there's a lot of energy coming in here. We've got a lot of blue on the in the cards already as well. There's a lot of things concluding, whether this is going to be, work life, home life, you know, moving, whatever it is that you've been kind of teetering on the edge of. It feels like it's actually going to come to a close. The answers that you need are going to be coming through. It's kind of like you're going to be able to see the wood for the trees. And look at that, we've got this massive full moon here in this picture. But what's really interesting is we've got this, you and your loved ones are safe. We've got this new moon in Cancer card. So let's just get a couple of cards here to clarify and to elaborate on why these cards are here. But we've got this new moon in Cancer card coming in. Okay. Yeah, so we've got this new moon in Cancer card coming in. So this is going to be a new start for things of the home, things of life, things of energies of family life, right? You know, and how we communicate with those, and a brand new cycle beginning here, which is really, really, really nice. Like, things are going to just get clearer, right? You know, you're going to be able to maybe delve into those types of conversations that you haven't been able to delve into before. We've got blue, like I say, coming up a lot here. And blue is very much a communication and throat chakra color, but it's also, it's very calm and very safe, right? And I love that this is right in the middle here, this new moon in Cancer card. So something very very new is going to kind of like energetically shift, and that could very well be with Venus moving into Virgo, right? It could very well be to do with that. It could very well be to do with Saturn, that planet of karma, going direct, right? And things, and actually taking, because it's going direct, is it in Scorpio? I can't remember. No, it's Mercury in Scorpio. But what's really fascinating here is that, you know, maybe with the energy of Saturn going direct and that energy of karma, you know, you can actually take a more kind of direct approach with loved ones this week, because that energy is just going to clear to be safe to actually have those conversations, right? Whatever it is that you're trying to achieve, though, they're saying, hey, you got to hold your vision this week, okay? So it's going to be, it feels like it's going to be kind of like a hold on to your hats type of energy this week, because we've got things wanting to conclude. But to conclude, sometimes things have to shift, right? And that can make us feel a little bit uncomfortable as that contrast appears, to really just, you know, move out the way anything that's lingering, right? So we've definitely got hold your vision here. And we've got these two cards coming out to clarify the week. Let's get a third one. Thank you so much. Yeah, look at that. So we've got honouring your true feelings coming out. It actually feels like these two are the other way around, because I was thinking about this card as I pulled the first card here. So so we've got raising your standards coming out here to talk about, look, this is a full moon eclipse, right, which is very powerful, this card. And this is about actually really getting vocal about what it is that you want. Like, you know, when you're doing affirmations, when you're thinking and visualizing and kind of trying to get into that alignment with what it is that you want, you know, make sure that you've got those high standards coming in. You know, it's like be specific with the universe. You know, if you're looking to move home, like what is that feeling all about? You know, be really broad about that. You know, be really broad about that to get that really, really high frequency, high vibrational feeling. And that's how the law of attraction is going to work for you in this way, because you know what? We're starting the week off by raising our standards around what we want to conclude. So whatever it is that you've been trying to achieve this week, you know, make sure that you really set out to draw in all aspects of that desire, right? It's not enough just to say, oh, I just want, like if we're talking about home, for example, oh, I just want it to be, you know, nice. You know what I mean? That just kind of sounds kind of like vague and ugh. So really actually get high in there with what it is that you really, really want. You know, do you want your home to be serene and content and, you know, this, that and the other? We've got honouring your true feelings coming in here. So that already elaborates on what energy was coming through with this card originally, right? With the, you know, with being able to speak about things that you maybe not have able to, that you may have not been able to speak about prior, because of the energies cosmically and things like that going on. But look at this, we've got hold your vision and problem resolved. So we've got conclusions at the start and problems resolved at the end, you know. And we've got have faith in your dream still coming through here, which is what it's all about. It's like the theme of the week, you know. The doorbell might go in a sec, you guys. If it does, I do apologize. Hard to tell when the postman's going to arrive here. But we've got that energy coming through really, really strongly. So I always love that. So I want to find out now what's supporting us? What energy is supporting us this week? Like, what energy is supporting us? What are we shifting here this week, right? What is moving for us? And an emotional, let's have a look at emotions first, and then we'll look at physical. So we've got Council of Light coming in. We've got answering the call coming in. And we've got breaking the chain coming in. So emotionally, we're really having faith this week. We're really having faith this week and really seeking that alignment coming through. Yeah. So this week, emotionally, we're really seeking that alignment. We're really tapping into all the other energies that are surrounding us, all the other light beings, all the other, you know, ancestors that have passed, you know, angels, guides, ascended masters, the universe, the fey realms. You know, we're really tapping into all of those and really just connecting on a soul level. It's like that emotion is going to reveal to you what your soul wants you to be doing. Like your inner being, what does your inner being want you to be doing? Because we know that if something feels fun and good and expansive and just, you know, all encompassing, then, you know, that's key this week emotionally. That's key this week to notice that, because that's what's gonna actually help us move through this this energy of the week from wanting to receive, like wanting to actually hit the conclusions and actually resolving the problem. So we've got answering the call because it feels like this energy this week is going to be really, really intensified a little bit with helping encourage you to really seek that alignment and that truth of what it is that you're here to do, not what someone else has told you for years that you should be doing and what's a good job or what's, you know, what you should be doing with your life, but actually really tuning into what your soul wants. This is supporting us this week. And we, look at this, we've got Break the Chain coming up. So we're actually going to be doing a lot of healing. And Cancer energy is always about like that mother healing. So the fact that this card's come out with a new moon and the Break the Chain, you know, this, once again, this is a really good time, you guys, to actually book an Akashic session. Just because this healing and rewriting the future and ancestral patterns, all that karma to... that you want to release and actually pinpoint that inner child work, right? You know, that's the session that when you book that, you can shift so, so much because you're going up into your Akashic records, right? So you're looking at things not from the earth level, right? You're looking at things from the angelic realms and actually going where time does not exist and all your soul's lives are, right? So very, very, very powerful week to book an Akashic session, especially with that full moon coming in. But let's just see here. So we've got Break the Chain coming in as well. So on an emotional level, there's going to be a lot of support coming in for you and alignment for you. And that can make you feel a little bit uncomfortable at times, right? Because you're maybe going out of your comfort zone, right? You're maybe shifting out of your comfort zone. But oh my gosh, you guys, when you actually do break that pattern, and this is a really fun one to look back on, like time is circular, right? But it often kind of repeats the same type of patterns year after year. So have a little think, like, you know, do you always move house around this time of year? Or, you know, does something always kind of happen this time of year? Because if that's a pattern and you've not yet managed to break it, this is the time that we actually break it. This is the year that we actually break it. So emotionally, we've got a lot of support coming in for that. Now let's have a look at physically what's shifting. What's shifting for us physically? This... this week. Okay, I love this deck of cards. Melissa Virtue's actually just launched her virtual deck of cards online again. I was like first in queue to get that. So if you do want to, like all of these decks of cards, barring this one, all of these decks of cards are available online. but yeah, this one's just come back out online on an app and I'm so happy about it. So I'll link it in the comments below. For anyone that does like this deck, because it's one of my favorite ones, especially for the dream work that we're doing, that soul growth as well. But let's have a look. What's physically shifting for us this week, you guys? Let's have a little look here. What's physically shifting for us this week? Thank you. Location. Problem solving. We've got a lot of problem solving energy coming through here. Dress rehearsal, right? Look at this. Yeah, psychic abilities. Behavior patterns. So there is a lot of reoccurring themes that are shifting here that are coming to light in this reading specifically, especially when it comes to, you know, that psychic ability. Amethyst is a very protective stone. You've got quite a few amethysts in various different you know, clusters around here, because it's they're very, very good for actually tuning in and clarifying, you know, third eye and crown chakra and those types of those higher chakras. But they're also really, really fantastic at just protecting you as well from other energies and other people that are shifting things that maybe aren't as sovereign in their energy yet, right? That are still learning. But physically, what's shifting this week is it looks like we've got a lot of physical movement happening. So whether that is it doesn't feel necessarily that it is to do with holiday. It feels like you may be, most people watching this may be looking at actually maybe moving house. The energies are very, very supportive to do that. Different location, right? Different path, different, whether it's a job or whether it's a home, this card coming up here is like, you're going to be very much supported to shift something that is out of alignment or is kind of concluded. You know, you're kind of done with it. So whether that's the home that you're living in, whether that's the area you're living in, whether that's the vocation that you currently have, if you have been feeling over the past few weeks a little nudge to get more aligned here and shift, then physically this is a very good week to do that. A lot of problems that have been arising around around this different vocation, this different job, this different location, right? Home. A lot of those problems that have maybe seemed quite closing in, right? You know, kind of, you know, when something feels constrictive and you can't really see the answers, those answers are definitely going to come through here in relation to this week. So we just have to open our ears, right? Open our ears, open our heart, and open our eyes to see what we haven't seen before, and to feel what we haven't felt before, and to connect how we haven't connected before, or maybe energetically it's been a bit more difficult to connect previously. This week it's actually very much supported. And look at this, we've got dress rehearsal card coming up. Dress rehearsal is a type of dream, you guys. It's a type of dream, but what it's great for is actually showing you different choices. So maybe pay attention this week to what your dreams are showing you, like, and not just your dreams, but your daydreams as well. Like, have a little, be cognizant of the choices, of different choices that may be coming through here for you. Because, you know, the universe is always trying to bring through the most expansive, beautiful options for you, but oftentimes we can close down quite a bit. What this card is coming up to show us here is that there's actually going to be so many more choices, and many choices that you haven't maybe considered previously or haven't been able to come forward because of other energies cosmically and not. So there's a lot of yeah, look at that, clearing the throat here. So this is a really, really, really exciting three cards to have come up as the physical things that are shifting, to be honest with you guys, because I don't know about you, but I know I've been waiting for something to happen, and I've been acting on things and doing the healing and doing, and you know, breaking the chain and listening and tuning in and tapping in. But this week I woke up this morning, I already felt this massive shift. So I know that many people that are going to be watching this are going to be feeling this as well. So just be really open. It's like you're this beautiful vessel just to receive all the answers and the supports that the universe is trying to provide to you, that the angels, that the guides are trying to provide to you. And now you're just a little bit more open. It's like you've took the lid off your cup and you can receive it, right? So that's a really, really, really incredible energy coming through. I want to just have a look here. We're going to get a couple more cards before we wrap this up. So we've got some great energy coming through emotionally here. You know, we're going to have a lot more support emotionally. It's going to be a lot clearer. That line is going to be a lot clearer. It's like, imagine, I don't know if you guys can remember back to, 10 years ago or whatever, and you're on your phone, and the line, you know, used to be like a lot more crackly, right, than what it is now. And it's a lot clearer now. We can have video calls and, you know, and phone calls, and the communication can come through very, very clearly. That's kind of like what this is coming up saying, right? That's like what this is coming up saying, that just things are a lot clearer this week emotionally for you, and directionally and supporting wise from the spiritual realms, and physically as well. That's because of this. Physically, you know, you've got a lot coming through here. A lot wanting to shift and to change, and you know, started off with this conclusions within reach, and have faith in your dreams here, holding your vision. It's all coming through. So who do we have? I just want to find out here, who do we have? Do we have any specific ascended masters that are supporting us this week? So let's have a look. Who is supporting us this week with all these changes? Who have we got coming through here? Thank you. We've got Horus coming through. You are seeing the situation accurately. And El Moira, clear and shield your energy. So, and look at that. Apollo's coming in about your strengths here, focusing on your strengths. So your strengths are, so wherever your strengths lie, that's, to tap into those is going to be a great, great advantage for you. But this clear scene is going to come through so vividly here. This week, and we've got Horus like really looking after that. Look at that, we've got the Eye of Horus here right in the middle, and the direction is the direction that this ascended master is going to bring is just going to be fantastic. You're just going to revel in it. It's going to be really, really wonderful. But in order to really maximize on this, you guys just make sure that we're keeping shielding and clearing your energy. So make sure you're doing some cord cutting at night, you know, in the morning, at night, and just putting a shield of light around you through the day, just making sure that, you know, whether you work with the dragons and you call in the fire dragons to burn up anything lower around you, whether you work with your unicorns, whether you work with angels and an orb of light around you, whatever that is, just make sure that you're being a little bit more diligent about it this week, so that you can maximize on the energies here. We've got a lot of fantastic stuff happening. A lot is clearing through for you, and a lot of stagnant energy is shifting, which is really, really nice, right? So I think I'm going to wrap it up here for you all, but thank you so much for tuning in. Do put in the comments, what is it that you're trying to shift this week? Let me know what are you trying to shift this week, because there's a lot of this energy coming through for you here. And if you resonated with this, if this helps, do share it with friends. It means a lot to help the channel grow. So thank you so much, everyone, for being here. I love you all. If you are curious about Akashic sessions or about or even a reading to get a little bit of clarity around which direction you need to move in, this is a great week to get something like that booked in. So just message me either on my Facebook page or my email in the comments below. And I will see you all next week. So much love to you, so many blessings, and thank you all for being here. Bye for now.